Every year, a team of dedicated, talented individuals and companies join forces to make the Ethnic Business Awards a success. Now, one company we've been privileged to have with us over the years is Ethan Group, our major sponsor. Please welcome to the stage Tony Jaja, co-founder and executive director of Ethan Group. Thanks so much for joining us, Tony. I just wanted to give everyone a little bit more background. So Ethan Group is Australia's largest privately owned provider of next generation IT and telecommunications services. You offer systems integration, technology sourcing, business systems architecture, telecommunications and ICT services. Ethan Group is committed to building and managing communication, application and infrastructure solutions and more than 2,000 medium-sized businesses, multinational and government clients, and they all rely on you as a strategic partner. These include banking, education, government, health, insurance, construction, utilities, manufacturing, and retail. That is quite a commitment, Tony Jaja.
It is.
Yeah, how's it going?
Very well, thank you. Very busy.
Now, Tony, Ethan Group, I guess you could call it a true Australian success story. It's considered one of Australia's largest IT and telco service providers. Now, we've spoken a lot tonight about building bridges. How about for you, what sort of bridges are being built in terms of the work that you do?
Good evening, everybody. Honourable guests, Bishop Antoine Charbet-Tarabé, and ladies and gentlemen, and of course the finalists. Ethan builds the bridge between business and technology. Mm-hmm. With only 10% of Australian businesses that have undergone a digitalisation, you know, being a great IT company, being a great telecommunications company, just isn't good enough anymore. Mm-hmm. You know, we're forced to understand our customers a lot better, companies in Australia, their business challenges a lot better than we ever have before. As international competition, you know, approaches, and businesses, which are startups, in essence, are making the most of the deficiencies that exist within the processes of businesses throughout Australia. So we help customers on that journey. You know, 23 times more likely are a business, you know, to win a new customer if they've got to focus on data. 19 times, you know, more likely are they to be profitable if they're serious about digitalisation. Now, it might be a little bit biased, but I think Ethan Group is probably one of the best and most successful businesses when it comes to helping organisations, you know, move forward ahead with their digitalisation approach, with the, you know, the holy grail of excellent customer service. That's what we try and help our customers achieve, and by doing so, they leave the competition afar.
Well,
hope
we know.
That answers the question.
Yeah, we know the digital space, of course, is so important at the moment to businesses across all sorts of sectors. But last year, you spoke to us about the importance of innovation. I want to know from you what Ethan Group is doing to help foster and develop more innovation here in Australia. How are you moving forward in that way?
Well, the pace of change, which is something that I spoke about last year, it surely isn't, you know, slowing down. In actual fact, it's accelerating. You know, businesses are challenged to stay competitive, to evolve and to renovate their existing systems, their operations. We kind of look at innovation quite differently. We look at it from two perspectives. The first perspective is to take a customer or take a business on the journey of, instead of innovating, why not consider renovating first? Let's look at the business's processes, its systems, and let's see what we can do to improve its customers' experience. And by doing so, typically that leads to loyalty and longevity. The other area of innovation that we tend to focus on is to take our customers on a different journey, which is focused about themselves. We believe the best people and the best candidates to innovate within an organisation are themselves, because they love the business more than anyone else does. It's the stakeholders, it's the people within their business, and we empower them by giving back what is a very unique commodity called time. By giving back time, they're able to focus on their business And the way we do that is by taking away all the necessities, the things that just should work, but sometimes they don't in IT and in telecommunications. And we're very good at doing that.
Thank you so much, Tony. I guess tonight we want to celebrate the successes, but I want to get real with you. I want to hear some frank admissions. So along the way, I'm not going to go too personal, don't worry, but people will often talk about in business, won't they, about the things they wish they could have done a little bit differently. So you're going to bare your soul here for us, Tony. Let us know what you might have done now that you've got the benefit of hindsight. Is there anything you might have changed or done differently?
Well, my beautiful wife, Gael, and I have a year and a half old at home who...
You're not going to say you wish that that was
No. Who we mistakenly made the common error of letting him sleep between us over the last year and a half. And let's just say he's not open for negotiation on leaving the bedroom, so I'm going to have to leave myself. But that would definitely be something that I'd change if I could.
Well, thank you so much for your honesty, Tony. It's been a pleasure.